we have a near-perfect war. And there it is. Amazing, almost perfect war. We were one star short. Now let me show you my attacks here, and then I'll show you the Town Hall 11 attack, and we'll see how it goes. This is the Queen Walk. Going to speed it up, and Town Hall 10, not max Town Hall 10. So should I three-star this base? Well, it's definitely doable for sure, especially with these max Valkyries, yes. I mean, Inferno Towers are still tough to take down. It requires quite a bit of skill still, and some patience. Not the greatest jump spell placement at all. Really kind of a bad funnel at the beginning. But it doesn't matter. I still is able to power through and really take out, especially that middle core, the dragons, the Inferno Towers, and all that good stuff. Again, my Valkyries kind of spread out a little too far, and so most of them didn't go towards the center, so not a good funnel. Make sure you funnel with Valkyries too. Again, since the base was so weak, I was able to get the 3-star, but if anything had happened, or kind of a fluke attack at all, it would have been bad. Bad going for sure. Just wanted to let you know, kind of another story of the day here, but I remember this 2015 Super Bowl ad of Liam Neeson, Clash of Clans. Well, that was the most viewed and best liked ad of the Super Bowl. And the fan base from YouTube, they voted it as the second best ad in all of the Super Bowl. So pretty cool. If you haven't seen that video, go watch it. I might give a link in the channel below. But just wanted to share that. That's pretty neat. That Clash of Clans, you know, it's just an app game. Who would have thought an app game on your phone? I mean, when I first started playing Clash of Clans, I thought it was just a kind of another Candy Crush, nothing really that special about it. But then I soon realized what a great game this was, and really changed my mind. But here we have a Town Hall 11 versus Town Hall 11. Again, not another max Town Hall 11, but one of those Inferno Towers are upgraded to max. And with that Eagle Artillery, this is a tough base. I mean, you know, it looks easy because it's made look easy, but look at the nice funnel that he did. He brought in the Golem on one side, Queen on the other, Valkyries right in the center there. I need to work on the funnel and learn from AJ how to funnel my Valkyries to the core of the base, because if they had spread out and he didn't create the funnel, those single target Infernos would have taken out them way quicker. All those units in the middle of the base there, those defensive structures, would have been hitting the Valkyries. So, but from here on out, though, he was able to, you know, pretty much destroy this base. Again, he did lose his queen, so it's kind of scary here, but he has enough Valkyries left, and the king is still up and running, so that was very critical. But those Valkyries, there's just plenty of them. Now, time could have been a factor here because there was no queen, so that would have been a problem. But luckily, he was able to get the rest of these buildings down before time ran out. So amazing. We, you know, our clan is very awesome. If you want to join, please send us an invite. Just say, you know, you saw it on the channel, the YouTube channel. I'm going to just pick some other videos here and see what we have going, because I want to just show you a variety of attacks from our clan, because we have a lot of good attackers in Alpha Kings, especially at the Town Hall 9 level, which is very critical. You have to get 3 stars at the Town Hall 9 level. So I wanted to bring you this one. This is a low hero attack. Very cool here. You can still 3-star with low heroes. This is level 15 heroes. You know, not strong at all, but he did a nice job a little early on those wall breakers. The problem was he didn't clear those outside units first, but it's okay. The Golem was able to get in towards the center a little bit, but he lost more damage than he should have. A little late on those wizards as well, but it doesn't matter. The 3-star is there. It's just these things, you know, if you, for whatever reason, might go wrong, you could actually lose the war and lose the battle. Here he brings in the hogs as we speak. He still has tons of wizards left, and the Golem and King are still up, and the Queen. So this is pretty much over. He's able to place his hogs, and he saved 3 heal spells for the hogs. So that is huge, if you ask me. But this base really didn't have a chance, because Champ, a solid attacker. Very solid attacker. Not the greatest heal spell up there, but it's okay. Those skeleton traps are really deadly. Since he has 3 heal spells, he's able to get into the core and save his hogs to the very end. So just going to speed it up there. Another great attack from Town Hall 9. Again, Town Hall 9s win wars. And now with the Town Hall 10 being able to be 3-starred very much
easier, especially Town Hall 11 versus Town Hall 10. I mean, you got to just wipe out that base. I mean, with the Grand Warden and the Valkyries, until they change that, Town Hall 10s are so weak to the Town Hall 11s. I mean, I'm 3-starring Town Hall 10s, and I'm only a Town Hall 10 with not even maxed heroes. So, you know there's something there that needs to be fixed with the Town Hall, with the maxed Valkyries. I wanted to bring you here... Here's an attack, a Magical Envy Town Hall 8. I don't bring you many Town Hall 8s lately. I used to do more early in the channel. You can see some of those videos. But here he's going to bring in a lot of wizards and the golem to make sure he takes out that clan castle with the dragon. Because if the dragon stayed alive, the hog portion would have failed. Now, it kind of fizzled out. That was a wasted heal spell on those golems and wizards. Didn't need that. Save that for the hogs. Now he only has two left. So it's important to remember to save the heal for the hogs. The golem doesn't need it, because or the wizards, because they just die too quickly. The hogs are really what's key here. Now he did save, as you can see there, two wizards and an archer tower for archer for cleanup. Very important. Always save at least a couple wizards and some archers, maybe some goblins like that for the cleanup. Otherwise, you'll run out of time because they reduce the time. So always don't just spam all your units, or else you're gonna find yourself running out of time and not getting that final attack. I mean, that final 3-star. So there you have it. Let's go on up to right here. I guess I'll do another 3-star attack from me, just to give you a chance. But we didn't get that 3-star in the Town Hall 11. And that's what's the real tough kicker there. Sometimes you win, sometimes you don't. I'm going to really speed this attack up. Again, another queen walk. I'm just going to letting her do her thing. And that way, it'll go well. So she's going to do her thing. The Valkyries are coming in from the south. They're going to go towards the court. I don't really lure the clan castle. The reason being, those Valkyries are so quick. The clan castle can't really do much to them. And so by the time they drop their, the loons actually drop their little bombs and the dragon does the breath, they've already moved on to another building. So I don't really lure the clan castle when I'm using Valkyries much. I just kind of make sure my wizards are behind the Valkyries and they'll take out the dragon. So there you have it, some great attacks from our near perfect war. And one day we are gonna get the perfect war. I think we've gotten it once before. Oh no, I can't remember. I don't think we've gotten it before. But anyways, doesn't matter. We'll get it in the future. Thanks guys for watching. Appreciate it. See you next time. Halo.